How's it going, everyone? It's Sam. I want to talk to you today about my conviction rates on some different stocks that I own. So I've talked about a lot of stocks over the last couple months. So I want to go through every single position in my Webull portfolio, tell you which stocks I feel strongly about, what I'm thinking on some other stocks, and I think you should stay through to the end because you could hold any of these, and I think you might like what I have to hear, or you might have a little bit more caution going forward, or just be able to look for some things that I'm looking for from these stocks. I am going to tell you about some stocks that I sold recently too, and my thoughts on those, because I sold 5 different stocks recently. So if you guys like this, please leave a thumbs up. I really appreciate that. I think that there are a lot of good stocks on this list. We're up 28, 29% just this week. So a lot of the stocks that we've been picking have done really well recently, like FUBO, like MP Materials, like Tattooed Chef, and I'm going to go through each one of them. If you guys want to get this in the future, you can hit subscribe. Also, I want to hit on a couple things real quick because there are some deals that I think you should know about. So this is going to be a little bit of a different format. Usually I put up my screen from my computer. We're going to use my phone today, so we're recording on the old phone, using the new phone. I wanted to hit on the fact that SoFi has a bonus. If you guys do want it, there's a link down in the description. You can get $50 if you deposit $500, and they usually run some kind of deposit bonus too if you set up a direct deposit for $75 or something like that. They have some other deals too on there, so definitely check that out. You can see it on the screen here. Also, I just started working with BlockFi. I have just $100 in there just for the opening deposit. I'm going to put a lot more in there, but they pay up to 8.6% APY, and it's kind of crazy because I had the deposit going yesterday, and I pull it up today, and I have 2 cents accrued interest, which, you know, isn't a lot, but usually it would take me like 2 months to get that in a normal bank, and I get 2 cents every day just on $100. It's actually a little bit more than 2 cents, so I am putting a lot more in there, but if you want to check out, there's a link down below. Definitely check that out. And then last thing, Webull is still running their 4 deposit bonus. So get 4 free stocks if you deposit $100. You can get other stocks too if you refer other people. So you can get up to 6 stocks, I think, if you refer someone else and then they get the stocks too. So definitely check that out. Refer your significant other or your friend or something like that, and you can get 10 stocks for free. So let's start going through my positions, because I think there are a lot of them on here that I haven't hit on in a while. So CleanSpark, a company that I just bought yesterday, a company that I really like. CleanSpark, I just covered, so if you want to see that video, you can. But they're a company that tries to solve the microgrid problem. So in the future, we're talking about having a lot of EVs, right? A lot of electric vehicles, and there's only so much electricity to go around. There really needs to be an increase in efficiency to be able to handle the increase to the grid. So CleanSpark is one of those solutions, right? They really focus on helping efficiency, saving money for their clients. They went from $1 million in revenue to $4.5 million to $10 million. Now they're expecting $20 million this coming year, but they just acquired a Bitcoin mining company, and I really like this one, so I might be buying more even now. I still think that it's a little bit low for where it will be in the future. I could see this being a $50 stock. Now, it has moved up a lot. It was a $2 stock 6 months ago or a year ago. So this one is a little bit riskier, so it lowers my conviction a little bit just in the short term. But long term, I think it's a good play. Long term, I still think it's cheap where it is now. So pretty high, strong conviction on that. Next one, WPF, fully trazamine. This one's in talks with a cloud company. I feel pretty good about this one for the fact that it's so inexpensive. So right now it's $11.40. They can't really fall under $10, but we don't know if they will actually merge with the cloud company. They were only reported on one news site that they were in talks of this, but it hasn't been official yet. So I think it will probably jump up after they announce it, but right now I feel medium conviction just because it's not official, but I feel pretty good because it is a low cost, so limited downside. Thunderbridge is another one we're up pretty good on. Now, Thunderbridge is a company that's merging with Indy Semiconductor. I feel decent about this one. The thing is, it is pretty inexpensive now at $11.66. I bought it at $10.75, though, right as I heard about the merger. So if you guys want that a little bit quicker, you should follow the channel. Also, I tell my Patreon members even earlier because we heard about it really early. I did research, but I don't know much about the semiconductor industry in general. So I feel okay, not great about this one. So I might sell off. I plan on selling off before the merger, but I might sell off even earlier than that. The next one is Tattooed Chef. I feel really strongly about this one too. This is a company that's growing very quickly. They're expected to grow 50% next year. And I apologize for not breaking down the numbers here because they're not on the screen like usual, but I feel good about this one. This is one that I like. This is one that I plan on adding more to, even though I have a large position. QELL is a company that's looking at merging with Proterra. So this is kind of just whispers right now. But I think if they do come to a definitive agreement, that will be awesome. I think it'll jump up. If they don't, I think it'll fall down. GHIV is a company that's actually a SPAC that pays a dividend. I feel okay about it. I might sell out before the merger date, but we'll see. It's still pretty inexpensive though, so limited downside before the merger. DMYD is one that I really like. I pointed it out at $11.50. They do kind of the back end data for a lot of the big sports betting companies, and they work with a lot of different sports leagues. So really the only big one that I can think of off the top of my head that they don't work with is the NFL, but they work with the NBA, NCAA. They work with a lot of other types of leagues, and they are kind of like the Palantir of sports betting. That's how I kind of think about them. Up a lot on them too. BFT, I feel pretty good about their payment processing company. I have a lot in the company, at least for this portfolio, about 15% of my portfolio is in there. And I like them overall. They don't have huge revenues, but hopefully Bill Foley will be able to increase the revenues and margins and profits going forward. MP Materials up a lot since I bought it, up at $39 now. Bought it at $24.30. I feel good about this one too. They mine for rare earth materials. I like it long term. I'm still holding it even though I'm up 62%. FUBO TV, I'm up 110% on now. I wish I had bought more, but you know, you can say that about a lot of companies. I feel good about my position now. I wanted to add more. I literally said yesterday I was going to add more, and then it went up 50%. But I still like it long term. It's not one that I'm planning on selling off anytime soon. Again, and if you want more background on any of these companies, you can probably just search my channel for it because I've talked about all of them before. VGAC, a SPAC that is run by the same guy that brought Virgin Galactic. He is a serial entrepreneur, Sir Richard Branson, and he's looking at getting into EV. So this one is still early on, $11.64. We got in at $10.74. I like it long term, but I realize that there could be downside after the merger happens, just like a lot of these other SPACs. Open Door up 35%. Feel pretty good about that one. We got in late at $22.89. Still up. I'm holding on to that one for a while though. Pershing Square Tontine Holdings. They are actually down a little bit since I bought them. I feel pretty good about it though. They're one of the biggest SPACs in the world. Now, Bill Ackman is kind of like a blue chip or blue collar kind of investor. He invests in like the food industry a lot. He wants a mature unicorn. I think it will probably be a good value whatever he buys. But I realized too that it is pretty expensive right now. But it also starts at twice the cost of the normal SPAC. It started at $20. LGVW up a lot today. And I'll show you exactly how much all these are up. And I'll show you the stocks I'm selling here or that I sold here in a second. But feel good about this one long term. Pretty small addressable market, but I think that they can do well. ARK Invest has been buying them a lot. We'll see where it goes. But I'm holding on to that one. CIIC, we actually bought it at $13.50 a share. Rode it up to 30, sold half of our position, then we actually sold off the entire position and then bought back half of it. So it says that our cost basis is $29.79, but really we bought all of it at $13.50 and then rode it up, sold it, bought half back, and that's why it reset the cost basis. So we're up over, or we're up around 100%, I believe, because we sold half at the bottom, and now this is just all profits for about $493 worth. Then Teladoc, I like long term. We're up 15%. I want to add more, but you know, there are only so many companies I can add. Switchback Energy, I like this one a lot. I'm not selling, even though it's at pretty much all-time highs. I think it's nearing all-time highs, up 125%. NEO, I don't have much of a position. I bought some that jumped up and then it fell back down, and it's just back and forth, and I just found other stocks I wanted to invest in. Qualcomm, I'm up over 100% in other portfolios. When I transferred this over, though, it reset my cost basis. I transferred it from Robinhood, but I like it long-term. SPCE, very high risk, high reward play, especially with their last test flight not going great, but I'm still up 12%. I plan on holding this one long term. Facebook, very high conviction play. Again, this one reset my cost basis when I moved it over here too. I think I'm around 200 or something in my old portfolio. I was buying some at 150 in my M1 finance portfolio, but I'm holding this one long term. Walt Disney, one of my highest conviction plays. I plan on buying a lot more of this here soon with a tax advantaged account. And then last one that's not even on the list is JP Morgan Chase. I like that one a lot too. I'm going to add a lot into that tax advantage portfolio. So I guess overall, if I had to give my highest conviction for these stocks, I feel very strongly about FUBO. Always easy to say after it's up so much, but I felt this way for a while. I like Teladoc too long term, but it could have some potential competitors. I like CleanSpark a lot because of their multiple avenues for growth. I think that one's going to grow very quickly. SBE, I really like long-term. Also, DMYD, I like that one for the fact that they are growing, that the industry is growing, the sports betting industry. Tattooed Chef, I really like long-term. And again, I'm just giving like half of these I feel really strongly about. Disney, I like a lot long-term. I feel really good about that one. Also, JP Morgan Chase. That one is just one that I really want to hammer home and want to buy a lot more of because I don't have enough right now. So hopefully that helps clarify a little bit which ones I like the most. And then just looking at some of the ones I sold recently. So you can see here in my orders, I sold five different companies a couple weeks ago. I sold APXT, and you're looking right in the middle here. APXT I sold because I just didn't have much in the position, and I don't really understand the business model like I do. It's helping with a Microsoft cloud, but the thing is, I don't know the difference between a good product and a bad product, so you know, try not to be too hard on me. Canoe, a spec that I just didn't have a large position in. It was up 60%, and I sold all these at a profit. Ride stock, I only had 3 shares. I was up a good amount too. I just wanted to reallocate some of this money. NBAC I sold, and then RMG I sold. So NBAC, you know, we wrote up, I think, 86% when it jumped up a lot. We bought in right before it jumped. And then RMG were up a good amount too. You know, with all these, yeah, they're up since I sold them, but so are all the companies I bought too. So I don't feel bad about selling them. I needed to trim down my portfolio a little bit because you can see I have 22 positions in this portfolio. Now just looking at how they're doing today, you know, LGVW up 20%, FUBO up 17%. You know, a lot of people were wondering if it was too late yesterday, and I said no, if you're looking long-term. And then people still didn't buy. Teladoc up a decent amount, Switchback up 7%, CleanSpark up 14% after it was up 20% yesterday. I feel good about all these companies, MP Material. If I didn't want to hold these companies, I would just sell them, I'll be honest. So if you ever want to know what my conviction rate is, and it's a company that I'm holding, it's high enough that I still am holding it. So I hope you guys like this, a little bit of a different video. I don't know if it'll get many views because these videos don't typically do that, but hopefully you like this. Let me know if you'd rather in the next video have me go through with like today's numbers right here, which just shows like the percentage that's up, or if you want to see like my actual profit and loss, you can see them here. I think most people would rather see like when I bought into the companies, so they'd probably rather have this page. But thank you guys so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Again, if you want those free stocks, you can check out the link down below to Webull. Also, Bitcoin just hit 24,000 the other day and they sell it on Webull. But if you want interest on your Bitcoin, like I said, you can sign up for BlockFi. You can get, I think, 5 or 6% interest or APY on your Bitcoin. So it'll pay you in Bitcoin if you want, or you can invest. What I'm doing is putting in stablecoin, which is tied to the US dollar, and I can have it pay me in whatever I want, whether I want it to pay me in the stablecoin that's tied to the US dollar, or I can have it pay me in Bitcoin. You can definitely check out that link down below to BlockFi. Also, again, if you want the link to SoFi, get that free money. I mean, it's a 10% return if you deposit $500 and just get $50. You know, even if it's just like, hey, let's go out for food now because we got an extra $50. Definitely check that out if you want it. Thank you guys so much. I really appreciate everything that you do. Every like, every subscribe, every comment, every sign up for whatever is down below helps me out. I hope it helps you out too. Thank you guys. I appreciate it. Happy holidays coming up. I still plan on doing a video every day, but just hint on that first. So thank you. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.